Okay, so we have this chart. P stands for percent, F for fraction, and D for decimal. So I guess you understood what I wanted, even though I didn't put any instruction, right? Okay, so just write 16% as a fraction, and then as a decimal. Okay, so yeah, why don't you raise your hand if you want to give the answer? So 16% is what?
16 over 100.
Okay, and what else? The decimal for 16% is what?
0.16.
Okay, any questions on that? Now, supposing I want the fraction to be in lowest terms, did anybody try to reduce that to lowest terms? What's your answer, Shanika?
4/25.
Very good. Did everybody get the first row? Did it? Okay, good. Okay. Now, next row, I have 5/8. I gave the fraction. I want you to give me the percent as well as the decimal representation. What do you think is the easiest thing to do? We gave so many options, right? Let's see. Any other hand? Just Monica?
Percent.
Not that I don't like Monica. Okay, Monica, what did you do?
To change it to percent, I divided 8 into 5.
8 into 5, right? So 8 into 5. Okay, and then?
And then I got...
So you put a 0, right? Decimal
zero.
Point,
decimal
0.
Point 0. And then I got 6.
Uh-huh. So 6 times 8 is?
48.
So you subtract 48 from 50, you get 2, right?
Uh-huh, and then it's 0. Then I got 2.
2.
Times 8, 16.
Oh, and this is nice, right?
Yeah, and then I add another 0. And then I put 5 times 8, 40.
And that's it, right? Okay.
Yeah.
So therefore, the decimal representation right away is there, right? It's 0.625. Did you guys get that? So it's just dividing the numerator by the denominator, okay? And once you have the decimal representation, it's actually very easy to get the percent, right? What do you do to get
the
percent?
The
David? So what is the answer for percent, David? 62.5%. Okay, did you guys get that? Okay. Next, 0.09 is the decimal representation.
Why did you move the decimal twice?
That's the rule, right? Well, we explained it last time. It's not just because it's the rule, but I know I can. But it is the rule, but there's a meaning to that, really. Well, let me explain. If you want to just go back, 0.625 as a fraction is what? 625 over what?
1,000.
1,000. Yes. Now you want percent, right? Percent is over 100. I'm not even sure I explained it this way last time, right? But if you want it to be over 100, then you want 10 to be chopped, right? Okay? The decimal point in the 1,000 is where? It's here. So if you move it once to the left, you get 100, right? But what you do to the denominator, you also have to do to the numerator, so you have to move this also one to the left. That's one way of explaining it, right? So therefore, this is going to be 62.5 over 100. When you have something over 100, that really means percent, right? So 62.5 over 100 is really 62.5%. Does that make you happy? I know. So, but then last time we just said, oh, the fast and easy way to remember it is just move it to the right, okay, and put the percent symbol. I think it was Chris first. Chris?
But the point is between the 6 and the 0. Oh, so you moved it twice.
Twice, right? Isn't it?
Yeah.
So twice to the right. Where did I get the over 1,000? Well, because it's the place value, right?
There's
you have
0.625.
There are 3 digits to the right of the decimal point, remember? So that's the thousandths place, okay? So that's an easy way of doing it. Okay, next, 0.09, raise your hand so that we don't have anarchy. Linda, which is easy? Do this one or this
percentage.
One?
Percentage.
Percentage is easy, it's just going to be 9%, right?
Just
move it two places to the right, right? Okay, 9%. So you have that. And then, what about this guy? Anybody? Wait, Angela?
9 over 100.
So that this is easy. Okay? Then I give you a mixed number with a percent. 6 2/3% Okay, did anybody get that?
Change it to the proper fraction for fraction.
Okay, Paul, do you want to help me? So 6 2/3%.
20/3.
Is 20/3%. Now, how? What can you do with a percent symbol? You can write the percent symbol as what?
One over 100.
That means something, okay? Do not ignore it. Don't just say, oh, I'm done. So the answer is not 20/3, but you need a 1/100, right?
Yes.
So therefore, that will become what?
20/300.
20/300 is one answer. If I did not say a word about reduced to lowest terms, then that's the answer, right? Okay, so let's put one answer here is 20/300. But then if I wanted to reduce to lowest terms, what's that in lowest terms? I can chop the zero, right? I get 2/30, right?
That's it.
So that's, is that it?
No, I don't know. 115.
1/15, right? So the lowest terms is 115. Yeah, you agree this is the hardest row, right?
How'd you get 300 on the bottom?
Three. Remember the rule for multiplication is what? When you multiply two fractions, you just multiply across, right? 20/300.
Why does it equal 1 times over 100?
Because that's what the percent
That's the definition of percent. Percent is 1/100, okay?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
All right, how do we get the decimal representation? That's hard, right?
Yeah.
So what can you do? Well, you have a fraction, 1/15. What can you do with a fraction, 1/15?
You can just divide it.
Just divide, right? Okay, so you have the fraction 1/15, just divide. So divide 15 into 1, of course you cannot do that, right? So therefore you need to put a 0, right, and a decimal point, correct? But still, unfortunately, you cannot do it, so put another 0, right? Then add another 0 here, and now of course you have 100 now. And 15 can go into 100, how many times? 6? Do you get 90? Right?
Yeah.
You get 90, so therefore you get a 10. Okay? Oh, and then I think I see something will happen here. Add another 0, bring it down. So again, you get 100. And you get 6. Wow. Okay? And then you have what? Again, a 90. So do you still want to continue, or you know the story already?
Right.
You should add a line to the top.
The story is this will continue forever. So the answer is you can just put 1 6 and then put a bar on top, right? So therefore, the mixed, the decimal representation of this is 0.6 with a bar on top, okay? Actually, this is interesting. This is the decimal representation. How can you write the 6 2/3% another way using decimal?
The question.
If you have this, right? You have the decimal representation is 0.6 with a bar, which is the same as 0.066666 and so on and so forth, right? How can you use this representation to write the percent? Let's just review. What do you do?
6/10.
So move the decimal point.
Move the decimal point this time where?
To the right.
To the right, right? So therefore it will be what? How many places?
Two.
So it will be 6.66666, but it won't finish. So therefore you just put what?
A line on top,
a bar on top. Do you understand?
Yeah.
So that's another way of writing 6 2/3%. So you can have 6.6 with a bar on top percent. Okay? Can we just do one more before? Because I don't think I gave you. Can I do it here? So let's just review. If I have the percent, let's say I have 0.